हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम योर डॉक्टर संजय कुमार सर. ब्रॉट इन विच चैप्टर दैट इज चामराज वडेयर 10th. इवत्तिन विषय हत्तनेय चामराज वडेयर अन्नु कुरितु तिळिदुकोळ्ळोण. चामराज वडेयर 10th वाज बोर्न इन द ओल्ड पैलेस इन मैसूर ऑन 22nd फेब्रवरी 1863 एज द थर्ड सन ऑफ सरदार चिक्क कृष्णराज आर्स ऑफ द बेट्ट द कोटे ब्रांच ऑफ द रूलिंग क्लैन. His father died about a week before his birth. His mother, Rajkumari Puttamanini Devi, was the eldest daughter of the Maharaja Krishnaraja Vadaiyar III. Following the failure of heirs male, Krishnaraja Vadaiyar III decided to adopt Chamarajendra. The adoption was done on 18th June 1865 and was recognized by the British government of India on 16th April 1867. Chamraj Vadaiyar 10th ascended the throne. So, yav rithiyagi simhasanam alankarisidunna tilidukolana. Krishnaraja Vadaiyar 3rd died on 27th March 1868 and Chamrajendra Vadaiyar 10th ascended the throne at the Royal Palace, Mysore on 23rd September 1868. However, since 1831, the Kingdom of Mysore had been under the direct administration of the British Raj, which had earlier deposed Krishnaraja Vadaiyar on the allegations of misrule. Later, the Privy Council of the United Kingdom ordered the reversal of the British East India Company's decision to annex Mysore by the Rendition Act of 1881. The princely state of Mysore was reconstituted and restored to the Vadaiyar dynasty. Chamraja Vadaiyar 10th was groomed by the British to take charge of the administration. He was officially handed the reign of the governance on 25th March 1881. Reign. Although his reign proved to be a brief one, he left an indelible mark on the Kingdom of Mysore. He was aptly added by Rangacharlu 1881 to 1883, common era, and Seshadri Iyer from 1883 to 1901, two of the most competent divans. He instituted the representative assembly of Mysore Kingdom in 1881. This was the first modern democratic legislative institution of its kind in princely India. He sponsored the famous journey of Swami Vivekananda to Chicago in 1893, common era. He gave primacy to women's education and founded the Kannada Bojaswini School. He gave a fillip to the industrialization of the Kingdom of Mysore by instituting several industrial schools and conducting the annual Dasara Industrial Exhibition. He facilitated the founding of agricultural banks to help finance farmers and initiated life insurance for ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಂಥ ಅದ್ಭುತವಂತ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಚಾಮರಾಜ ಒಡೆಯರು ಮಾಡಿದರು. ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ಇವರು ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳು ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಮೈಸೂರು ಸಂಸ್ಥಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಲವಾರು ಶಾಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ತೆರೆದರು. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ಮಹಿಳಾ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಇವರು ಭೋಜಸ್ವಿನಿ ಶಾಲೆಯನ್ನು ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಮಹತ್ವ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಿರ್ಮಾಣ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ರೈತರಿಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡೋ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ. ಇವರು ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಅಮೂಲ್ಯವಂತ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಚರಿತ್ರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಮರಣೀಯವಾಗಿವೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬಹುದು. ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಸೂರು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಓವರ್ ದೇರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಮಿನೆಂಟ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಪ್ಯಾಲೇಸ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು, ದ ಲಾಲ್ಬಾಗ್ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್ ಹೌಸ್, ಓರಿಯಂಟೇಷನ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಸೂರು, ಮಹಾರಾಜಸ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಮೈಸೂರು, ಮಹಾರಾಜ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಮೈಸೂರು, ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಮೈಸೂರು, ಲ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ಡೌನ್ ಬಾಜಾರ್, ಡಫ್ರಿನ್ ಟವರ್, ಮೈಸೂರು ಜೂ, ಫರ್ನ್ ಹಿಲ್ ಪ್ಯಾಲೇಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಚಾಮರಾಜ ಒಡೆಯರ್ 10th. ಪ್ಯಾಟ್ರನೇಜ್. ಚಾಮರಾಜೇಂದ್ರ ಒಡೆಯರ್ 10th ಆಫ್ ಮೈಸೂರು ಇನ್ 1877. ಚಾಮರಾಜೇಂದ್ರ ಒಡೆಯರ್ 10th ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್. ಈ ಒಂದು ಚಾಮರಾಜ ಒಡೆಯರ್ 10ನೇ ಚಾಮರಾಜ ಒಡೆಯರು ಸಂಗೀತ ಮತ್ತು ಕಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಅಭಿರುಚಿಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದ್ದು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರೋತ್ಸಾಹವನ್ನು ರಾಜಶ್ರೀಯನ್ನು ನೀಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಎಚ್ ಕೋಟ್ ಬೂಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವೀಣಾ ಸುಬ್ಬಣ್ಣ, ವೀಣಾ ಶೇಷಣ್ಣ, ಕೆ ವಸುದೇವಾಚಾರ್ಯ, ವೀಣಾ ಪದ್ಮನಾಭಯ್ಯ, Mysuru Karigiri Rao and Bidram Krishnappa, among others. The Maharajas was a violin virtuous himself and used to daily provide accompaniment to Veena Subbanna's vocal and Veena Seshanna's Veena performances. His favorite kirtis included Sujana Jeevana and Lavanya Rama. He was also connoisseur of Javalis Kritis. Javalis are genre of Karnataka music. H.H. Sri Chamarajendra Vadiyar, 10th by Raja Ravi Verma. So these are the important contribution by the Chamaraja Vadiyar 10th, especially art and music. Many of the prominent musicians were patronized by the Chamaraja Vadiyar 10th. So tamma ondu darbarnalli hattu halavaru sangeetagaranna rakshisiddu poshisiddu avarige rajasri needi Karnataka itihasakke kalle mattu sangeetavanna kodigeyanna kottidanta kirti Chamaraja Vadiyarige hoguttade. Family avara ondu kutumbada bagge tilkolabekandre in May 1878 Chamarajendra Vadiyar married to Vani Vilasa Sannidhana Kempananja Ammani, our daughter of the Arsu of Kalale, a prominent nobleman of Mysore state. They had 4 sons and 3 daughters, of whom following survived a adulthood. Chamaraja Vadiyar died of the diphtheria in Calcutta on 28 December 1894, aged 31. He was succeeded by his 10-year-old son Krishnaraja Vadiyar 4th. His wife Maharani Kempa Nanjammani Vani Vilasa Sannidhana Varu served as regent of Mysore during the minority of their son. So here are some important referential textbook for the study of the Chamaraja Vadiyar 10th. A Conscious History of Karnataka by the Kamath Suryanath. Insight into Karnataka History by the B. Narasingharaju Naidu. History and Cultural of Karnataka by Dr. S. N. Shurudrappa. History of Karnataka by B.P. Hogar. Cultural History of Karnataka by K.R. Basaraju. Freedom Movement in Karnataka by Dr. M.E. Krishna Rao. History of Karnataka by Dr. B.P. Desai. So thank you for listening my lecture. ನನ್ನ ಒಂದು ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸವನ್ನು ಕೇಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ತಮಗೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು.